Now, the next thing we want to do is sign up for a free Dropbox account, so a cloud-based storage system where we can also back up all of our PDFs, and we'll talk about why later. But right now, let's just install Dropbox and make sure that we have everything set up with all of the installs. So I already have Dropbox.com conveniently pulled up, and we want to create a new account. So I'm going to create an account. And we also want to download Dropbox and get that onto our computer as well. So we're going to download Dropbox. Okay, so now Dropbox is installed onto my computer, and we can either put it in the dock if you're a Mac person, but also it pops up in the right-hand corner. So I opened up Dropbox, and you'll notice that I have two important folders that I've listed. The first are Mendeley files, and the second are Mendeley watch folder. So if you could set up those two folders within your new Dropbox system, that's going to be really important. And we'll talk a little bit about it later, but generally speaking, what we're actually going to do is connect, and we're going to store all of our PDFs. Instead of storing it locally on our computer, we're going to store it in Dropbox. For me personally, I have a home computer, I have a laptop, I have an office computer, and I have computers in the research lab at my university. And because of that, I want to be able to connect all of my desktops to one particular place. So rather than storing everything just on one computer locally, I actually store everything in Dropbox. And that way, if I get a new computer or I'm working remotely on multiple computers, I can still connect all of the multiple desktop applications. I can feed everything I put into my system into my Dropbox folder, so that way I can access everything remotely, and that way it takes time out of having to duplicate things and making sure that everything is being connected from one computer to the other. So it's for that reason that I really I generally put everything in Dropbox and connect it through Dropbox, because that just automates the process for me depending on any computer that I might be on, and that way I don't have to work on the online system, but I can keep everything stored within Dropbox as well. It also makes file sharing a little bit easier if I want to send some files to my students, whatever I want to do. I can easily share folders, and I can share files that way. The watch folder we're going to talk a little bit later, but what the watch folder allows us to do is if we're downloading any type of PDF from a system such as ERIC or JSTOR or PsycINFO or any type of database, generally what happens is when we download those, they give us some weird name that's really not describable, a file name that's not describable to what that actual article is. And so generally what you have to do is then you have to type in the author and the date and whatever that might be. When you connect a watch folder now to Mendeley, the minute you drag that file into the watch folder, it's automatically going to convert to a standardized title using the author's name, the date, and part of the title. So that helps in another step also, so I don't have to go through and figure out what file is what file by these random file numbers, but just throwing any file I'm interested in into the watch folder is automatically going to transform the title of the PDF, so now I know very specifically who the author is, what the date is, and what the title is, and I can easily find it, and then from there I can throw that into Mendeley, and we're going to talk a little bit about that more as we move through the different modules. But just that gives you the broad basis of why we're actually connecting everything now to Dropbox. So you've installed Dropbox, and you want to make sure now that you have two folders. You have your Mendeley files, and then you have your Mendeley watch folder embedded within your Dropbox. I hope you enjoyed the video and found it helpful. If you did, make sure to give us a big thumbs up and like the video. If you haven't done so already, be sure to subscribe to our channel by clicking the link above, and make sure to check out some of our other videos. We'll see you again soon.